My name is Valona, or V, and I'm from Lithuania. I came to Glasgow School of Art because it seemed to offer the best course in terms of what I was looking for. I really wanted to learn more technical stuff, just like techniques and so on, because I felt like I can't design if I don't know how to make it. So that was perfect for me. And during that time here, I've learned a lot of traditional and new techniques that I've used a combination of in my own work. That was laser welding and stone setting, using different materials as well and combining them together using those techniques that I've learned. My work is inspired by the image of a strong, independent female, and I've always been interested in fashion, so my goal was to create a strong fashion jewelry collection that I would be proud of, because that's what I want to do. And what I wanted to do is to create quite big jewelry, quite statement pieces that only people who dare to wear it would wear it and would be brave enough to wear it. Well, the process, as I said, it's definitely stone setting and laser welding, because combining steel and silver, I've tried soldering it together, that didn't work, so I had to come up with alternative ways to do it. Well, the plan is to go back to Paris and work in a fashion house designing fashion jewellery. That is like going there long term.
I'm Madeline Holloway and I'm from Oxfordshire, and I chose to study in Glasgow sort of by chance, but after my art foundation I heard a few good things and people said it was tricky to get into, and I thought I'd give it a shot. And I heard the jewellery reputation was good and I knew that I wanted to do jewellery. So for my degree show I focused on plants and organic forms from the garden, mainly those which I collected myself from my own garden, and I pressed 21 flowers which then continued to inspire the rest of my organic degree show. Well, all my works felt like organic, natural form based, and this time I went down that route but elaborated, so it was all got things from the garden. Inspiration was Derek Jarman's garden at Prospect Cottage. Well, my main processes were cuttlefish casting, because of the texture and the organic texture that it gives, and porcelain to add a delicate aspect to it, also incorporating texture too. It was mainly silver, but porcelain would be entwined into it, using catches or cold connections and resin glue. I've made necklaces, brooches and earrings. I use a lot of development in my sketchbook. Drawing really helps me with design development, but mainly for this project I did a lot of lino cutouts, and each lino cutout that I did inspired each piece differently, texture-wise and visually. So I imprinted the lino into the porcelain. It was a newfound love for porcelain, because I'd never worked with it before, and I found it really just such a different way in working with silver. It was more sort of relaxed, I guess, and you could sort of mess up and sort of redo it quickly again. The more times you redid it, the better it got, and I found it's a sort of different type of process which I really enjoyed. Next, well, I'm hoping to eventually start my own business one day, but before that I'd like to work for a bigger company in London or Copenhagen to get some experience before I do my own thing.
I'm Iona, I'm from the south side of Glasgow, and I came to Glasgow because it's the school that everyone knows about, it's the reputation for it. I did the portfolio course as well, which was really good, and I found out exactly which course I wanted to apply to here because of it. Looking at Scottish Fire Festivals, I was looking at all the sort of symbolism behind it, so the circle and the use of the three and the transitions between different things, so like transitions of seasons, transition between light and dark. So I started looking at burnt wood as something that was more tangible, something more permanent that I could represent as a physical form. So I was taking casts of that. I like working on a larger scale because I like eye-catching pieces. I like pieces that kind of, they don't have to complement the outfit, they kind of become the outfit. And it becomes something that people are more interested in, they want to come up and look at it and see exactly what's going on there. I use casting quite a lot because it became a sort of permanent way of preserving charcoal textures. It also let me work in wax so I could build up different forms and I could manipulate those shapes so that I could get sort of bigger pieces to fit with what I was looking for. I think straight away I'd like my own studio. I'd like to kind of take a bit of time to develop the things I've started doing this year because I've started a lot of new techniques and things that I've not necessarily used before, but I think in future I would love to have a casting workshop. I would love to set up my own business and help other people kind of making their castings.
Hello, my name is Tara Casali-Bell. I'm from Suffolk, Cumbria. And I chose to come to Glasgow. I was aware of the reputation of the school and I'd been just once before and I really liked the city and I was lucky enough to get in. So this collection was inspired by memory, and I was kind of thinking about kind of like childhood antics of making kind of something out of nothing or from very little, and yeah, just kind of like this making in a spontaneous manner, which was kind of my approach to begin with. And then I was going back into the pieces that I was making and adding details from found objects that you might kind of recognize parts of them, or they might seem familiar, but yeah, so it's that kind of like play of association as well. So I was using some watch parts and different components from pocket watches for the kind of sentimental value and just the timely aspect of the kind of, yeah, it's like long in the time gone by. So some of the process that I used is quite broad. I started with chasing to riveting. And I think the process that kind of ran through the collection was the looking at the surface of the metal and the kind of application of different surface treatments, whether that was like heat application to bring out different tones and colours, or oxidising a few pieces, or patination as well. So it wasn't particularly led by a specific technique. It was quite experimental. Well, some of the details that I took from the found objects were cast in silver and bronze. The collections within the body of work, they seem quite diverse, but each one kind of budded, like stemmed out from the next. I think, so yeah, by kind of creating this collection, I'm more drawn to making objects and rather than kind of jewellery. Yeah, just on that scale, I prefer working. And yeah, I suppose I'm more interested in how something might work and making. I would continue making and kind of try and put the techniques that I've learnt to use, and yeah, continue exploring vessels and objects. Yeah, maybe aspire to kind of learn more about precious metals. I enjoyed chasing. That's something I can see myself doing in the future.
My name is Nicole Gavin. I'm from Glasgow originally, and I always wanted to go to the Glasgow School of Art because growing up in Glasgow, it's like an iconic building, and you hear about all the like cool stuff that people make there. So I just thought it was like a good place to kind of aim to be, I suppose. So my collection, I've always kind of been interested in like crystals, gemstones, kind of really highly structured work. And that's kind of stuff I wanted to create. So when I go to like galleries and museums, I like how pieces like pull you in, you really want to examine them closely. And I think that the kind of crystals did that for me. So I thought that would be a nice starting point for my collection. And yeah, I just wanted to create pieces that were like really interesting from every angle. And that's where I started. So. I used vinyl a lot in my work because I thought it was kind of the future of kind of jewellery and 3D design, and I wanted to push myself to see what I could do with a new technology that I didn't have that much knowledge of before. And looking at such three-dimensional objects as a starting point, it didn't make sense for me to make things that were kind of flat or one-sided. I really wanted to make things that were interesting from a variety of angles, and I would never have been able to make those structures completely by hand. So I decided to use Rhino to 3D print and then complex casting techniques to have a nice finish. Well, it's kind of a bit up in the air at the moment. I'm thinking about going to Australia to maybe do a residency because my best friend's in Sydney and it would be nice to go out there, and kind of just want to wait and see what happens with new designers and then look into getting a studio. So that's the plans for now. Travel a bit beforehand.
I'm Ayla Christie, I'm from East Kilbride, and I chose Glasgow School of Art because I really wanted to develop my ability to generate ideas and just the ability to work on my own, but also like learn traditional making techniques that would allow me to really explore my ideas. So the way that I work, I enjoy using digital tools because I find that it's the quickest way for me to generate ideas, and I was inspired just by the graphic appearance of the tools that I was using. So the symbols and the icons that the digital tools represent, I wanted to sort of imagine how they would look in a 3D space rather than digital flat images. What's important in my work is the sense of variation that I create through each piece that I make. I also like, I enjoyed the challenge of creating interchangeable earrings so that the wearer could have a choice in the aesthetic of the pieces that they wear, so they could take a front and a back of one set of earrings and interchange them and then attach them to a brooch, and you've got multiple options of how you wear the piece. I also worked with kinetic movement in my pieces because I like the sense of surprise that people get when they pick up a piece, and the unbalanced weight of the piece makes it move, and it's the sense of play that that brings. Because I was working in a digital space, I was inspired by the symbols that I was using on a regular basis, and I wanted to reimagine just graphic icons as 3D objects. So to do that, I took just some of the symbols for example, the zoom tool, which was a magnifying glass, and I took it from Illustrator to Rhino, extruded it, and wondered how I could reimagine that in like just physical materials. So that led me to just taking 3D models and building them from flat layers of paper. So going back to the flatness again, but building up layers to make quite obscure three-dimensional objects that you're sort of unsure what the symbol represents. I developed a method of slicing the 3D models so that I could get individual layers that I could then cut from paper. Each piece could be between like 50 and 100 layers. And I used this process because it was quite an accessible method for me. I was using a vinyl cutter to cut the paper. So instead of having the turnaround of 3D printing where you'd have to wait, I could immediately get these models and then develop them, sort of expand my ideas and just keep exploring and pushing the limits of each piece that I made. So I wanted to make, just keep on pushing one idea. So I ended up making earrings. I made 64 earrings. I wanted a square number, and I just wanted to begin with quite sort of minimal forms, and through my process just develop new ways of seeing that object and pushing the idea forward. I would like to set up a studio and probably develop a more commercial line of jewellery using the digital slicing technique that I've developed, and push the limits of material and continue to expand my collection.
My name is Ruth and I am from Glasgow. When I decided to study jewellery, I knew I wanted to like stay in the city because there's a lot of really inspiring people working and doing like great things here. And in terms of like the art school and the course, I wanted something that was like that would have like a total like craft approach, and I would learn like a lot of like making skills, but also have like the freedom to be like working outside that discipline as well, and working in a kind of more like artistic approach instead of like just a strictly design one. And I feel like this course really allows for that. So it's about like materials and processes and texture. There's like a lot of like thought. It's like inspired by geology and water and bodies of water and what sort of impact they have on our landscapes and stuff, but also like a lot to do with like thoughts of time, like eternal time, and also like sort of like notions of like entropy and things like disarranging. The main body of work is made up with porcelain, which I really enjoyed using for like how like malleable it is before it's fired, of course. It allowed me to like, I was like slab building with it, so everything is like sort of like tube or like pipe form, before like it's like really repetitively hand textured. And I just like really enjoyed like the response that the material would have with that. And it's contrasted with like steel and plastics. It's like looking at like sort of like shifts in like geological time, and looking at sort of like more like primitive times, and like, yeah, looking at this sort of like in between of like the past and the present, and looking at like sort of like elemental impacts on the land, and then like human impacts on the land as well. And so like steel and plastic are like trying to like nod towards that, and also like sort of create like a sort of startling contrast. I would like to continue working with porcelain. I'd like to continue making wearables. I'd like to consider master's courses, and I'd like to continue to show work.
I'm Anna. I come from Glasgow, and I chose to study here because having grew up in Glasgow and having went to school in Glasgow, I just knew how good like the name like Glasgow of Art was, and we always get told like how amazing it was, and we get taken to the Grie Show every single year since I was in first year. We went to the fashion shows and went to absolutely everything, so I just really idolised the place. So I just thought, well, I'm just going to apply every single year until they eventually let me. The idea was, well, the theme was anxiety, and it's something that I struggled a lot with like during my time at art school, because a lot happens and things change, blah blah blah, and I just felt like it's something that stayed with me since first year. So I just thought, well, I think it would be good to like study that more in depth, because it's something that had been very much like a constant. So I just thought, and after speaking to like people in different departments and my friends, it's something like I notice a lot of like arts and crafts people struggle with. So I just thought it'd be really cool to like look at that and develop my ideas through that. Well, the initial process was I looked at the physical symptoms of anxiety, which was like a clenched fist, and I looked at the patterns and textures, and from that I took tracings and then layered all the tracings up, photographed them, made work from that, and then I moved into material. So I put these drawings on the material, printed them out, and I just thought material is good because you can manipulate it a lot, and I thought combined with metal and my hand castings, it kind of like was a bit abstract, so I thought it worked well with like literal castings of the hands. Well, I made a lot of brooches and neck pieces because I just thought, well, my neck pieces, like, I think look heavier than what they are, and that was the kind of idea behind it as well. Like, I wanted things that were quite light, but some of my pieces are quite heavy, and I really like the contrast between light and dark and like heaviness and lightness, and I just thought that worked quite well. I would hope to get a residency, maybe have more studio and put out more work, because I'd really like to be self-employed and make it like selling more work, designing more work, having it in galleries, maybe going to teaching later on at a university level, or yeah, because I'd quite like to like talk about my experience, because I feel like I've came so far in 4 years, and I think it'd be good to like maybe teach later on, but definitely right now I would like to just get my work out and have people see it.
I am Leslie McAlpine and I come from Motherwell, just outside Glasgow, and I came to Glasgow because my art teacher always promoted me to go to the best school, and that's where I'm here. I think I've always been interested in like the visual characteristics of like the Scottish landscape, especially with this term I've really focused in on like Slater and igneous rock. So I found like drawing, photographing and like rubbing really got me kind of started looking at what I'm really interested in, and especially with the whole aspect of people overlooking the perfection that I see, and also the detail and the texture. I feel like I've tried to bring that out in my stuff, in my full collection, and I feel like I've hopefully did that. I felt like this year was a really good start to like start clean on some techniques that I haven't touched on, or some that I really liked and some that I've just not had the time to do, especially with silversmithing. I started doing a lot of hands-on raising with my tumblers especially, and as well I found myself really working well on the computer, so using CAD, using Rhino, and then 3D printing, and obviously going into the lost wax casting. So I really enjoyed that. I did start kind of looking at techniques like chasing and engraving that I never had enough time to do, so I probably would kind of maybe go on and do that when I finish. And then obviously just hand fabricated skills, I've really noticed that my skills get so much better at the end of the term. I see myself, after new designers, kind of collecting my ideas and developing the skills that I already have, and also investigating some of the skills that I never had time to do in my actual fourth year. I see probably getting myself a studio and just developing all these skills. And I really liked obviously working one-to-one with my ideas. So I'd probably like to get like a couple of people working around me, so we can also share ideas, do exhibitions, and just invest.
I'm Alexandra Miles. I've come from Bermuda originally here, which is part of the reason why I chose to sort of apply here. It's just a good school, so when I got accepted, I was excited. And so I was looking at sort of armor and weapons, sort of both aesthetically and as sort of like a theme or concept. And so I started looking at how I could sort of combine man-made armor and weapons, like chainmail and stuff like that, with more like nature's weapons, thorns and shells and that sort of thing and just figuring out how to combine it together. And so I basically wanted to do silversmithing and jewellery as opposed to one or the other. Just because of time restraints, I sort of stuck with small objects as opposed to sort of the larger jugs and stuff like that. So I have spoons, I have a few knives, which I wanted to be, as it does kind of go with the weapons, but it also, there's not as many silversmithing knives that I could see, like silversmiths who do like work with knives, so I thought that would be an interesting sort of avenue to explore. I also like making slightly different things, so I made a pen set with like an inkwell and an ink blotter, so it's like a traditional old-fashioned sort of dip pen set with sort of more contemporary design. And for the jewellery, again, it was kind of statement pieces, big thorn necklaces, big chainmail necklaces and earrings and stuff like that. I made some spoons with cast elements of like thorns mixed with forge elements. I think technique is quite important to me, so I wanted to see how many different techniques I could combine as well. I had 3D printed cast elements as well as just sort of like thorns and sort of like regular cast elements with more traditional goldsmithing sort of techniques. So I like to try to combine them together. I think chainmail is something that I've always liked, and I've done them several projects sort of throughout the years. I've used that somewhat in this project, and I would like to expand on that more. However, I think the most sort of surprising or different technique for me this time was the cast elements. I haven't really done that often, so sort of figuring out ways that I could use the cast elements and still keep it sort of with the geometric forms that I had 3D printed and cast and stuff like that, I think that was new and sort of exciting, and I like to expand on that. I've used onyx for stone setting because I like to keep the black and white aesthetic sort of throughout the pieces. But yeah. So for my design process, a lot of the times as well as doing sort of like hand-drawn sketches, I like to do like CAD renders on Rhino, at least right now, as it helps sort of visualize in 3D what I want to make as opposed to drawings, which can be quite 2D. And sometimes I'll use those designs on CAD to print and actually use in my pieces, and sometimes I just use them as sort of a form of drawing to sort of present my ideas or to come up with ways to sort of fix the problems in the design before I actually start in the pieces. And also when I do design, I think the design process does, or the making process, sorry, does inform the design. A lot of it, I'll have a sort of rudimentary design, but the final piece will be different because when I'm actually working with the materials, things work differently. And I think that's important to be open to sort of changing the design while you're making it. I'd like to continue making as much as possible. I don't want to try to take a break in between that because I feel like it would be harder to get back into it. I don't have anything specifically lined up at the moment, but I'm just open to opportunities and looking into it.
I'm Audrey Ann Pesci and I'm from Hungary, and I'm getting Glasgow School of Art to develop my recent knowledge of making and conceptual work, as I was in college beforehand. So that was my aim, to fulfill my career knowledge, I guess. So I started to be interested in human interaction and social behavior in recent society, in between different social groups and between individual and social groups, and I got to be more specific and narrow it down to stereotype and prejudice, because I felt that is what we are recently very surrounded by, like every day, and we don't even realize it. And I thought, like, and just look around my own surroundings, look at my friends, family, even myself as a foreign student in here, like, how commonly we are surrounded by and victim of this social, like, not a good way of phenomenon, what we are in recent society. And I thought, as the jewelry making, as give so much possibility to express many things as a conceptual way, because because you have a visual language in your hand and you can, you know, during the years in Glasgow School of Art, you learn many techniques and many ways of approach to different subject and how you put your thoughts down to into materials and in physical object. And I thought as such a big power and a tool to work with, and I thought using jewelry as a tool to express these thoughts. I had quite a lot of experimentation about materials and different techniques because I wasn't really sure what are the best to express the concept, but through many experimentation, I got to the point to work with pre-enameled steel, like enamel and plain steel and silver clay, because it gives the opportunity to express different visual languages as well as gives the freedom of scale of the work which I need to express my concept through. I really enjoyed my fourth year as I could express my thoughts in a visual way and allowed me to focus on what I'm really interested in. And I don't look at myself like particularly as a bench student, but rather than an artist who has quite a lot of opportunity to use different visual languages, what I explained. And probably something what I want to take root on. So probably I would like to do more further education and probably something similar like doing projects and interesting conceptual work, I guess.
I'm Ailey Anderson and I come from Parkintellock, and I wanted to study at Glasgow GSA because I think I just felt like it was the right course for me at the time, and it still is. My degree show collection is focusing on kind of architectural structures and kind of like urban structures that you find within the city, and kind of how these are overlooked details and a wee bit of kind of industrial design that I might find interesting or inspiring and other people might not necessarily, and that was kind of my starting point for my work. The kind of forms came from the angular perspective that I was taking my photographs at, and I really liked how kind of my perspective on Glasgow was kind of shining through in the form of my pieces, and that's kind of where the geometric forms and the kind of score and folded sides come from. I like my pieces to have a bit of a life of their own, and I kind of like that the Jesmonite gave me options for kind of small scale and larger scale, and it was something that was quite kind of reminiscent of concrete, but it worked and played to like both of those kind of scales and functions. I think just the kind of whole casting of the Jesmonite came from the kind of cast concrete structures that you see throughout the kind of motorways and the city kind of details, and I wanted to kind of reincorporate that process that had been used industrially into kind of these small scale works that were kind of more precious and took a lot more time to kind of figure out. Also the Goldsmiths Bursary kind of gave me the opportunity to launch into a bit of silversmithing, and so it gave me the kind of funds for the materials that I would need to make like a larger scale work, so that's that. I would quite like to continue making, and obviously continue making what I've enjoyed over the past kind of year, so that's kind of really my starting point, and then I'd obviously like to kind of expand my business knowledge as well of just operating in the industry.